Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Lucia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. The Taiwanese Technical Mission, in conjunction with the Ministry of Agriculture, hosted a farmers' market in the community of Mabouya Valley. The main objective of the farmers' market was to encourage the purchasing of local produce. The initiative forms part of the enhancement of the efficiency of production distribution supply chains in the fruits and vegetable sector project that focuses on 7 crops over a 3-year period. The farmers' market showcased 3 of the 7 crops under the vegetable diversification project, as well as other produce such as honey and local wines. Chen Pinyu of the Taiwanese Technical Mission noted that this is the 5th farmers' market being held in St. Lucia. The enhancement of the efficiency of production distribution supply chains in the fruits and vegetable sector project commenced in 2019 and will culminate in 2021. The Department of Health and Wellness has informed that elective and day surgeries at the Victoria Hospital are suspended until further notice due to an increase in intensive care unit ICU patients. Dr. Eugene Ford says the increase of ICU patients is as a result of chronic diseases as well as a rise in violent cases. The medical director is appealing to the general public to put measures in place to manage their health. In addition, persons are asked to curb violence by changing their behavior to avoid complications which result in long admissions and ICU admissions. For more information, you can contact the secretary at the Victoria Hospital at 468-4203. UK resident British High Commissioner Steve McCready indicated that the British Consular Services is taking a new approach to assisting British nationals by focusing more on preventative measures. Out of this, the British High Commission developed, funded and facilitated the Serious Sexual Offences course for members of the Royal St. Lucia Police Force attached to the Vulnerable Persons Unit, VPU. The course was geared towards enhancing the capabilities of officers to deal with serious sexual offences. Minister for Tourism, Information and Broadcasting, Culture and Creative Industries, Honourable Dominic Fede, expressed gratitude to the British government for its continued support. The Serious Sexual Offences course commenced on Monday, the 27th of January 2020, and lasted a period of 2 weeks. The closing ceremony for the Serious Sexual Offences course was held jointly with the consular reception on the 6th of February 2020. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.